President Trump signed a bill into law last week making it illegal for anyone under 21 to buy cigarettes, cigars, or e-cigs anywhere in the country.
But as NBC2's Dave Elias finds out, it is catching a lot of people by surprise, even some business owners.
Yeah, many people that I talked to today were completely unaware that the age to buy tobacco or e-cigarette products was raised to 21. Some business owners telling me that the new law will have an impact on their profits. Others argue it was long overdue after dozens of vaping-related deaths and illnesses.
Nobody understands the vaping yet, and that's why people are dying.
The CDC reports nearly 50 vaping-related deaths and 2,300 lung injuries.
I had an incident with vaping where it swelled up my neck and I was in the hospital.
Randy Miller supports a new bill that makes it illegal to sell to adults under 21.
Keeping that away from as long as possible by making the age limit higher, by all means, do it.
It's not going to deter nobody from smoking. They're going to do what they want to do anyways.
Now, those under 21 years old can no longer buy tobacco or e-cigarette products at shops like this.
285, please. They can serve military. They're allowed to vote to elect a president.
Admitting the new law will hurt businesses like his.
I have talked to some other store owners and they were not even aware of, you know, the law.
Neither were many parents like Taylor Spencer.
It really should be illegal. There's no reason for 18-year-olds or 17-year-olds to even be vaping.
Others argue the law will have little impact on those already smoking.
Did it stop everybody from drinking? No. They found a way, and they always will.
Now, both Democratic and Republican lawmakers supported this change. So how did they raise the age limit with such little attention? Well, they attached it to a bill that avoided a government shutdown earlier this month. Live in the studio, Dave Elias, NBC2.